one of the things that we're often stuck dealing with is our appetite, you know, for food, right? And so, you know, humans, their psychology, their appetites is sort of evolved in an environment where food wasn't available on a regular basis for us, right? And so we crave things that are fatty, because that would be, you know, if we found a fatty meal, that's going to help sustain us for the next 2 days where we don't get a meal, for example. And so that can be used against us, because now we get plenty of food, particularly in the Western world, but our appetites and so forth are sort of hardwired for a creature that's not getting necessarily regular meals or meals that are as nutrient rich. And so we crave those fatty foods and those extra calories that the sugary foods that we don't necessarily need. And that's one of those evolutionary pressures that we have to learn to overcome. In terms of our evolutionary sort of sexual appetites, right? There's people that argue that humans are hardwired for polygamy, because a lot of the other primates are polygamous. But a couple things about that. One is that there's a lot of primates, probably about 10% roughly, that are monogamous. And so there's no cue we can take from primates in general that would dictate how humans are meant to live out their sexual lives, right? So you can say, you know, chimps and bonobos are our closest living ancestors. We split off from them about 6 to 7 million years ago, the lineage leading to them. Chimps and bonobos are polygamous, but they're polygamous in sort of different ways. Bonobos are very sexually active, much more so than chimps. But it's pretty clear, I think, in the evolutionary lineage leading up to humans, that there are things that would have favored more monogamous relationships, or an increase in monogamy, particularly in these small social groups where you needed more sharing of resources to help raise children that are more helpless, you know, when they're born. So there's a variety of different sort of evolutionary theories and evolutionary evidence that suggests that there might be some benefit to monogamy in modern humans and in other hominids in the last 2 million years. So should we take our cue from chimps and that's how we should behave? Should we take our cue from bonobos? Well, if we do that, well, should we take our cue from them on other behaviors? The fact that they will fight other groups and kill, like chimps from other neighboring group, is that something, oh, that's hardwired in us, that's what we should do? Or do we have the ability to recognize certain biases or certain things and recognize, well, there's more to us than just our evolutionary drives.